Canadian peacemaker. I was born June 10th, 1830 in Coney House, Colorado. my parents abandoned me when I was just a baby. My family and I were part of the Tabouwash tribe, one of the seven Ute tribes. although I am not a Yampatika Ute, I represent the Ute Indians. My childhood was full of helping with chores and learning the Ute Indian ways. Many call me White Singing Bird. I played guitar, sang three different languages, and was a worker at beating. I was also known for my beauty. I was well respected. When I was just 8 years old, I met my future husband. You're right. We were fast companions, and when I was just 16, we got married. A few years later, his father passed away, and he became chief. We lived happily until tension started to rise. One such tension was the Meeker incident. The Meeker incident was when the white settlers were trying to force the Yampatika Indians to go on reservation. The Yampatika Indians didn't want to go on reservation, and one of the Indians, Meeker, was trying to also force them, and the Indians got upset with Meeker and killed him in the night. I call this the Meeker incident many call this the Meeker massacre, but I call this the Meeker incident because the white settlers had a history of tricking us and not keeping their word. After the Meeker incident, I even spoke in an official trial. The Indians appreciated me after that. A few years later, Chief Uray passed away, and he was buried in southern Colorado. I was forced to go on reservation. Then I went to the government to try to settle things with the white settlers. Things didn't go well, and I went back home. I was then forced to move to Utah. I was forgotten by Colorado and all of my tribe. The last few years of my life, I moved back to Colorado. I died August 20th, 1924. I lived to be 94. I was buried in Utah and then reburied in Montrose, Colorado, next to my husband. Thank you. Bye. Oh, when you think of peaceful Indians, think of me, Chipita.
Oh, wait.
Mm-hmm.